at 6. We pressed for answers, and now the president of OU tells us that he is reviewing some policies after an alleged stalker makes his way back onto campus.
Police say Nasik Ferris wanted to kill a female athlete. KOCO's Anita Blanton is live. Anita, what does the school say it could have done differently?
Well, Paul and Jessica, President Boren told our cameras today that he wonders whether there should have maybe been a broadcast alert to help police find Nasik Ferris. And his words come as we're also getting an inside look at how this fan's excitement turned into a homicidal obsession from the victim herself.
Eyewitness News 5 confirmed today that when Nasik Ferdes drove from Ohio back to OU last week with his mind on murder, besides the female athlete he was after here, only select members of the faculty and staff were made aware of the potential danger in an email from Student Affairs.
When he did appear on the campus, he was spotted. Norman and OU police worked very carefully together. They used some technologies that I will not go into here to locate him.
Although no one was hurt, we asked President David Boren if he felt there was more that could have been done, like a mass alert.
And I'm going to second guess whether or not we should have used that system, perhaps to broadcast the description of the suspect.
Today, Eyewitness News 5 also obtained the emergency victim's protective order filed shortly after that female athlete was made aware of Ferdis's intent to take her life. In it, she tells of how his obsession began. She writes, "At first, it was just a Facebook friend request, then a message saying he wanted to meet me because he was a huge fan." She says it quickly progressed, and that on more than one occasion, he asked around telling people he was my boyfriend and that he loved me. It's a situation the athletes we spoke to understand.
And especially whenever you're out there just playing your sport that you love and you don't want to have to worry about those kinds of things.
Especially someone devising a deadly plan, to which she says, after reading the letter, I became fearful for my life and the safety of my family.
It's a scary situation. Now, in this email right here that was sent to certain faculty that we obtained, it says for them to notify their staff, but not to post this flyer that came right with it. It says Nasik Ferdes was seen on the campus in the Union and to call 911 immediately if anyone saw him again. In the studio, Anita Blanton, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
Anita, thank you. President Boren says he's already alerted the U.S. Attorney's Office to see if Ferdes violated any federal laws on his 900-mile journey to OU.